Hey everybody, I hope you're all doing well. I got my big man, my 10-year-old, my firstborn son up here in Washington with me this week. I'm very proud of him. He's a good boy. Anything that you want to say to anybody back home?
Hi, Mommy and Maverick and Madeline and Halo and Major.
You sure you want to say hi to all of them? You love them all equally?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Even your younger brother?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks for saying hi to everybody. As I said, very proud of this boy. Very proud to be his father. All right. You can go. Thanks, little boy. All right. Got a number of issues to talk about, mostly on the veterans front this week. I think it goes without saying that we will never be able to repay the debt that we owe to the men and the women who put on a uniform, who sacrificed, who went out there and served our nation. Two biggest things that I work on every single day is water and veterans. Those are the issues that I work on here out of this office, and it's an honor to work on those issues, but specifically on veterans. Helping to empower those who dedicate their life to service, including their families, it's the least that Congress can do. That's why I worked so hard to pass a few different pieces of legislation that work exactly on that front. One is Legal Services for Homeless Veterans Act. Now, this bipartisan legislation, it's something that I helped to introduce that basically lends a hand to veterans who might be struggling to keep a roof over their head after returning home from combat, but specifically directs the Secretary of the Veterans Affairs, the Department of Veterans Affairs, to provide grants to organizations that provide legal services to homeless veterans and veterans at risk of homelessness. Veteran homelessness, obviously a very serious problem that we have in a number of places in this country, and it can be solved by working together. It can be solved by working one-on-one with each veteran, helping them through the issues that they're dealing with, and letting them know that they don't stand there alone, that they still have battle buddies, they still have swim buddies, they still have wingmen, they still have people that are out there that are going to stand by their side and help them through the issues that they're struggling through. Another piece of legislation that we passed this week is known as the Gold Star Spouses and Spouses of Injured Service Members Leasing Relief Act. It's a long bill name, but its purpose is very simple. It's to protect military spouses from penalties that are associated with ending a lease early as a result of the death or injury of a service member. Now, for me, when I was injured, this was September of 2010. The situation was in about 5 or 6 days' time. It took about a week for me to go from Kandahar, Afghanistan to Germany to back to the U.S. and get back here. And in that week time frame, my wife had to pack up everything in the house that she was going to move to Washington, D.C. with for an unforeseeable amount of time. She had to find homes for the three dogs that we had at the time. I had an English Bulldog. She had two Jack Russells. Had to find homes for those dogs. Had to close up the house. Had to get all that stuff taken care of in a matter of a couple of days. And that's the kind of thing that military families face when there can be a death or an injury. Now, this is common sense legislation that addressed a problem that never should have existed in the first place. I'm glad that we're able to get it done and give service members' families the peace of mind that they need when they're working through those most difficult moments. My wife recounts when she first saw those uniformed service members showing up on our doorstep and what that was like and how the world changed immediately after that. One of the hurdles that doesn't need to be in the way of military families after that is the ability to terminate or get out of a lease or something relating to housing because all of a sudden they have to move to a military treatment facility or their spouse is unfortunately no longer with us. They gave the ultimate sacrifice in defense of this country. So a very important piece of legislation. Very simple, but very important. Final piece that I want to talk about, the House also passed the Protecting Business Opportunities for Veterans Act. And it's a bill simply to ensure that veteran-owned small businesses are put on a level playing field with other larger companies. It's something that we want to see our veterans as they come home from the battlefield and venture out there to become entrepreneurs have the best opportunity to go out there and do so. Make sure, as I said, level playing field. Great piece of legislation. Now, it's in that I just want to say we did have a couple of hearings on a couple of other things this week. One other hearing that I want to mention specifically. One of the hearings that we had this week was on the coronavirus. In the hearing that we had on the coronavirus, there was a number of things discussed throughout the hearing, but I think there was one important thing that was said to me by one of the individuals that was testifying. And what was said to me as I asked about the state of our healthcare situation, our healthcare facilities in this country, our healthcare infrastructure, was very importantly the difference between the infrastructure of healthcare here in the United States of America, the starting point for where our hospitals and our medical centers are at, and all of those places, our emergency rooms, all those places where people can go and be treated or get care or be diagnosed or potentially be quarantined, the starting point of all of those places, whether somebody can have access to oxygen or some of these things that we take for granted that in many of these other places, like let's say the Wuhan province of China, that were at a woefully lower level. That is one of the most important differences that we can see going on here in the United States of America as we prepare for the potential to combat the coronavirus as individuals could be diagnosed or individuals are contaminated with the spread of this disease. It's an important distinction that be made, that everybody realize the state of the United States of America healthcare system compared to that of South Korea, that of Wuhan province, China, of Pakistan or Afghanistan or other places, woefully different system, and to our benefit here in mainland United States of America. It's just one of those food for thought things to think about as we have the coronavirus very much in our minds right now and thinking about what's going on with that and different things that we should do. Now it's in that I will say this, it's always an honor to represent you here in Washington. I hope whenever you find the opportunity to get here to Washington, you take the opportunity to come here into the office, reach out to our office before you get here. Let us help you find tours to any places that you want to go, or maybe make recommendations if you want to get into the White House, or you want to tour the Capitol, or you want to know other Smithsonians to go and visit. Let us know. Let us help you through that, and I hope you get the chance to come up here in that. As always, it's an honor. And I wish you all the best.